Sat Sri Akal, everyone. It's time to tell you what happened in Madrid and what led us to what we're doing today, how this channel started. So I'd come to the Madrid airport to operate a flight from Madrid to Delhi. So as we were crossing the security point, I put my bags through the x-ray, walked through the metal detector, and everything was perfect till I went to pick up my bags. And I had a Spanish security guy who was just coming for my turban. And I had to put my hands up and stop him. I said, "Don't touch my turban." And well, he couldn't speak English. And we had a lady with us who was translating on his behalf and translating on my behalf too. So he said, "No, but I still need to check your turban." I said, "Well, the metal detector hasn't beeped. And I don't see a reason why do you want to touch my turban?" So, well, he was insisting. And I said, "Well, in that case, I do not want to clear security. I'd like to step back outside." And at this point, he let the Spanish lady know that that I couldn't leave and that he was going to call the police. He said, "Policio, policio." And I said, "Well, fine, you can call the police. There's no problem at all." And well, to our surprise, in less than 2 minutes, we had two tall policemen coming right at me. And again, they're insisting on touching my turban. And while I was talking to them, the security guy was gesturing that you either get your turban frisked manually, get a pat down, or put it through x-ray. Well, I said, I do not agree with both, and I'm just going to go back. Well, so they tried their best to pressurize me. My my crew took a stand, and they said, "Captain, we are not going to cross security too. We're going to stand here in support of your turban." So, well, I appreciated their efforts, and I told them, "Guys, you must go onto the airplane, and we have a set of passengers waiting to fly this airplane to India, and everyone has a destination to reach." I said, "Don't worry, I'm going to find the best way out from here and try and make it to the airplane as soon as possible. You guys should go on ahead and get things in order so we could fly to India." And I then sat thinking about how to deal with the situation, because it was getting a little awkward, and it was like seemed more like an ego issue than a procedural issue, because world over, Sikhs have the right to not let anyone touch their turban, and it is documented. It is nothing that I'm talking about. It is documented. So I called up the president of the Delhi Sikh Gurdwara Prabhandak Committee, Sardar Manjinder Singh Sirsa. It was 1:15 in the night, around that time, Indian Standard Time, and I sent him a message on WhatsApp, and I simultaneously gave him a call, and well, he picked up my call, and I could figure out he was sleeping, but I introduced myself to him, and he said, "Oh, Captain Saab, I do recognize you. Just give me like half a minute. Let me just get up and probably just turn the lights on. I'd like to hear what happened." So I explained my situation to him, and he asked me, "Did anyone touch your turban?" I told him, "Sir, no one had touched my turban, and I did not let anyone touch my turban either." And he told me, "Hold your ground, Captain. I'm going to get you all the help possible. The moment I put the phone down, I'm going to take this up with the highest authorities in India and make sure that your rights are not violated." And the man was true to his word. So I put the phone down, and while I sat there waiting, well, I decided that I needed to get through the security check and reach my airplane. And so I figured out that I should get up from there and leave. And well, as luck would have it, or with the blessings of Guru Maharaj, I just thought, let me just go and try passing security through another checkpoint at the other terminal. And well, blessings of Vaiguruji, the help of the Indian government and of Sirsa Saab. I don't know what really worked at that time, but I needed it all. And I walked through security. It just seemed like a breeze. I mean, no one even questioned me, stopped me, even checked my bags. So I just thought it was nothing short of a miracle, considering what was happening at the crew security checkpoint that I was being asked to put my turban in the X-ray. So I reached the airplane and continued back to India. Landed back in India, got back home, and was having it was almost 4:30 in the evening because we were delayed out of Madrid for various reasons, not relating to the security, of course. And I got a call at 4:30 in the evening from my cousin in London, and so she asked me that, well, is everything okay with you? So I was like, yeah, I mean, everything's okay. She said, no, something happened in Madrid and it's all over the news. And that's when I realized that Sardar Manjinder Singh Ji Sirsa had let the whole world know what was going on, and the whole world was standing in support of the turban, and especially my support post what happened in Madrid. I'm truly grateful to Sardar Manjinder Singh Ji Sirsa for what he has done. And hence, like I told you before, the Flying Turbanator, my YouTube channel, has been started for a social cause to help people who face similar situations or any kind of racial discrimination anywhere in the world. Send us an email with a brief video or a brief video message, which we'd prefer. And we would put it on our YouTube channel and let the entire world know what you're going through. And once it hits our channel, it will hit the right sources, and there will be a lot of hands coming out to help you. And we will ensure that it does. Thank you.